Now, it is very mysterious how the universe came into being. It's a deeply mysterious and interesting question.
And can I just interrupt? It's an old question, a very old question. Thomas Aquinas in the 13th century was asking the same question. He said there must have been a time when no physical things existed, but something can't come from nothing. That was his view. It's just been repeated by us.
Something can come from nothing, and that's what physicists are now telling us. I could give you... You asked me to give you a layman's interpretation. It would be a very, very layman's interpretation. When you have matter and antimatter and you put them together, they cancel each other out and give rise to nothing. What Lawrence Krauss is now suggesting is that if you start with nothing, the process can go into reverse and produce matter and antimatter. The theory is still being worked out. It's a very difficult theory, mathematical theory. I'm not qualified to answer the question, but what I am sure about is that it most certainly is not solved by postulating an intelligence, a creative intelligence, who raises even bigger questions of his own existence. That certainly is not going to be the answer, whatever else is.
George Pell.
Thank you. The trouble... Well, there are many troubles with Richard's teachings, but a fundamental one is that he dumbs down God and he soups up nothing. He continually talks as though God is some sort of upmarket figure within space and time. Now, from 450, 500 BC, where with the Greek philosophers, God is outside space and time. God is necessary, self-sufficient, uncaused, unconditioned. That's the hypothesis you've got to wrestle with. The second thing is that Krauss says nothing about the Big Bang coming out of nothing. Admittedly, he comes clean on about six pages from the end of his book, and I don't know whether Richard has read it that far because he gave it a foreword. What he says is what Richard is describing as nothing is a sort of a mixture of particles and perhaps a vacuum with electromagnetic forces working on it. That's what Krauss is talking about under the heading of nothing. And there's a very good review of this in the New York Times, not a pro-religious paper at all, where Krauss is absolutely denied and demolished, although... especially by his supporters claiming that he says things come out of nothing. He doesn't say that.
It's a matter... You can quickly respond to that.
You can dispute exactly what's meant by nothing, but whatever it is, it's very, very simple. And why is that funny?
Well, I think it's a bit funny to be trying to define nothing.